time now for the stock of the hour. Today, we're looking at a trio of companies, Celgene, Bristol-Myers Squibb, and Amgen. Shares of all three are higher today after Celgene agreed to sell a top drug to Amgen. Kailey, Leinz is here with more. And of course, for Bristol-Myers Squibb is also that they're announcing that share buyback.
Yeah, that is certainly part of it. But I think the bigger deal here and why we're seeing so much optimism and the shares up 3% today is because of this divestiture of Otezla, which is Celgene's psoriasis drug. They're selling it to Amgen for $13.4 billion. And of course, that was one of the assets that made Celgene an attractive target for that $74 billion takeover by Bristol-Myers Squibb. That one of their top-selling drugs expected to bring in about $1.8 billion this year. But the snag is that Bristol-Myers Squibb is developing its own psoriasis therapy. And so that was an antitrust concern, that overlap. And so they've made a decision to divest that, kind of clear the way toward the merger, finally getting the seal of approval. And Bristol-Myers Squibb said today they expect it to be approved by the end of this year. So there's optimism in that sense. And also the fact that they're going to get about $11.2 billion in cash from this and be able to use that to pay down some debt from that acquisition. So this helps them from a leverage standpoint as well.
Why is this such an attractive purchase for Amgen?
Well, Otezla is a growing drug. The sales are growing. It's expected to bring in $2.7 billion in revenue by 2023. And that's as some of the Amgen's former bestsellers are actually seeing their growth taper off. So this could be a significant growth driver for them. And it's interesting because they are kind of paying a lot for this. One analyst estimates that $13.4 billion price tag is equivalent to about 6.7 times 2019 sales estimates for Otezla. And usually when you have an asset being offloaded because of an antitrust situation, and the company is usually pretty eager to get rid of it, and you can get a lower price. That doesn't seem to be the case here. They're paying a pretty nice premium, and analysts thought they would only get in between $8 to $10 billion for that. So that's probably why you're seeing a list on the part of Bristol-Myers Squibb as well, because they're getting a lot of money for this, and again, helping to pay down that debt.